Hi there, good morning, happy Wednesday. My name is John Tracy. Thanks for stopping by for a little midweek morning encouragement from God's Word. I just look forward to this time that we can have together every week. And as we continue to see the adventure of 2020 unfold before our eyes, I just want to take a little time this morning to remind you and remind me of just how much we need God's grace on a daily basis. I don't know the specific concerns that may be on your heart today, but I do know that as I've talked with a lot of different people within our church family recently, there have been a wide variety of cares shared with me. They're causing my brothers and sisters to literally be on edge with anxiety and fear and anger. Things like health concerns, financial burdens, fear about government overreach and control in our lives, worry about, you know, what life is going to be like on the other side of the November election in America, the what ifs of that. Ministry concerns about the current state of the church internationally and domestically and even locally. Concern about job stability or anger over political and cultural issues that have surfaced in our society. Heartbreak because of the wayward condition of a teenage son or daughter or the fracturing of a marriage. I mean, I'm thinking of specific people. These are just a sampling of the kinds of conversations that you've shared with me, numerous people, in just the last couple weeks. There's certainly plenty going on to put our nerves on edge and spiral us into an unhealthy place of worry and fear. And so this morning, I'd like to just kind of huddle up with you for a moment as my family in the Lord, whether you're a part of our flock locally here at Keystone Bible Church in Odessa or Wesley Chapel, or whether you're tuning in from some other part of the country or the world. And I just want to be used by the Lord this morning as a voice in your life to remind you and to remind me that even though it may feel like the ground is shaking with instability all around us, I want you to listen and hear some stabilizing truths that our God has given us for unstable times. I'm going to read portions of Luke 12, where Jesus tells us over and over again why we don't need to worry, and actually what our lives are to be all about by contrast as his followers instead of characterized by worry. Listen to Luke 12. I'm going to start reading in verse number 4. I tell you, my friends, do not fear those who kill the body and after that have nothing more that they can do. But I will warn you whom to fear. Fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast into hell. Yes, I tell you, fear him. Are not 5 sparrows sold for 2 pennies? And not one of them is forgotten before God? Why, even the hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not. You are of more value than many sparrows. And then let me jump down to verse number 22, where Jesus says to his disciples, therefore I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat, nor about your body, what you will put on. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They have neither storehouse nor barn, and yet God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? And which of you, by being anxious, can add a single hour to his life, to his span of life? If then you are not able to do as small a thing as that, why are you anxious about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass, which is alive in the field today, and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, O you of little faith? And do not seek what you are to eat and what you are to drink, nor be worried, for all the nations of the world seek after these things, and your Father knows that you need them. Instead, seek his kingdom, and these things will be added to you. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give to the needy. Provide yourselves with money bags that do not grow old, with a treasure in the heavens that does not fail, where no thief approaches and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Over and over and over again, Jesus tells us here not to be afraid. He says, don't be anxious and don't let your life consist in the abundance of possessions. He says that we are of much more value than the birds that he already takes care of, and that our Father knows what we need even before we ask. So we should seek him for those needs in our lives. And then I love what he says next in this chapter. that because it is our Father's good pleasure to give to us, we should stay dressed and ready for action and be prepared for whatever He has for us, because blessed is the servant whom the master finds awake when he comes. Listen to verse 35. Stay dressed for action and keep your lamps burning. Be like men who are waiting for their master to come home from the wedding feast, so that they may open the door to him at once when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. Truly, I say to you, he will dress himself for service and have them recline at table, and he will come and serve them. If he comes in the second watch or in the third and finds them awake, blessed are those servants. But know this, that if the master of the house had known at what hour the thief was coming, he would not have left his house to be broken into. You also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Amen. There is a grand purpose behind all of these struggles in this life. God has a perfect plan, and Jesus most certainly is coming soon. And that reality should inform how we view all of the things that we are going to face on this day and every day to follow. So I hope Luke 12 can be an encouragement to your heart this morning to endure and to press on for the mission of Jesus Christ today. I certainly needed to hear it. And so maybe you would even want to just take a few more quiet moments, even right now, to just read through the whole chapter. Again, I didn't read the whole thing. So turn to Luke 12 and spend some time there. And before you move on into your day, let me just invite you to respond to it with me, to whatever Jesus has told us here, to fix our eyes and find our stability and our peace and our quietness of heart that we desperately need and long for, even in the midst of whatever instability and concerns may be capturing our attentions, to find our hope in Christ. He is more than enough for what we're going to face on this day. And so let's trust Him in all things. Thank you for sharing these few minutes with me. I'll look forward to seeing you again next Wednesday for more midweek morning encouragement.